here with you again to play your old time tunes from way back when. We'll try to do our best, we'll fill all your requests, make you feel like our special guest. One more thing that we all want you to know, we hope you'll enjoy the show. So sincerely from our hearts, it's music from the stars.
Pleasant afternoon to you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a brand new year here on the Polka Video Spotlight Show. It's January, and of course, we're here at Ron's Bungalow Inn with the King of Honky, Stas Golonka. Stas, good afternoon and welcome.
Well, Keith, it's a very fine time to be on your show. I'm glad you came down. It's always been a pleasure doing you on show TV. We were last time, was in the studio.
Right.
And we finally came down a live broadcast, so it's really good. Thank you very much.
Stanley, let's start out with our viewers, and maybe they're not acquainted with you, but let's talk about your history, how you got started in the polka field.
I started about over 30 years ago. I played for Pulaski Halls, 1961. I played, matter of fact, I'll be celebrating 30 years this year, 91.
Fantastic.
I played 1961 at Pulaski Ballroom. That was Eddie Blazonczyk's mother's on Ashton. That's my old neighborhood there on 1742 West Culleton Street. I went to St. Edward's Church, and I played for Eddie Blazonczyk's mother for her New Year's Eve when I had my first band. It's called Stas Golonka Polka Diamonds. That was in 1961. And that goes back about 30 years ago, so it's been a long time.
And then through the years, you've progressed, and you've come out.
So.
You've got, you got four or five albums to your credit?
We have five albums. We have three recorded on Bel Air Records and two on WRS. The first one was called Honky Style of Polkas on Bel Air Records, on Ample Records. And then one was called Here Comes Stas on Ample Records. And Bundle of Polkas was on Ample. And then the last two were on WRS, which were recorded in Youngstown, Ohio. And it was called Hooked on Honky. And the last one was called Stas Golonka, King of Honky.
In fact, it looks something like this here.
Okay.
Want to look at it?
Yeah, we'll look at it.
Did you play it on the show?
Of course, we always do. Tell me about what was your biggest inspiration? What really got you interested in the polka field?
In the polka bands, well, I always was a little Wally favorite. And my mother was always musically allowed to sing and play. And she went out when she was younger. She used to go see little Wally when he was playing. And I got it in my blood, and I just kept doing it. And around the neighborhood where I used to come from, in Ashland and 18th Street, there's a lot of polka band. Well, actually, a lot of musicians came from that neighborhood. Marion Lush came from 19th Street, which is only two blocks away. Eddie Blazonczyk came from Ashland 18th. Well, he was from Wisconsin or Ashland 18th, and I lived on Cullerton and Woods. So, and Lenny Gamulka wasn't too far away. He lived in Walcott. So a lot of musicians came from that area. And just hearing the music on Sunday mornings, all the shows that came on, and just don't know how I got started. Just keep doing what I do. That's all.
Tell me about back, you're going to be celebrating 30 years this year. It's 1991 now. Tell me, what changes have you seen taking place in the polka field over the last 30 years?
I think it's slowed down a little bit. I don't think it's as good as it used to be, but there are still a lot of good people out there that enjoy it, so I enjoy doing it for them.
Instrumentation-wise, you've got a lot of updated recordings, and everybody's using 24, 36 tracks now instead of used to be 8 or 4 even.
No, I don't use all as many channels. I don't need that many channels. I use less equipment. I just use 8 tracks, or maybe 16.
You've got a style that's all your own. Eddie, I think, tends to favor the country style. Lenny has got a little Eastern flavor to him, but you are definitely the honky dino sound of Chicago. Any particular reason why?
I don't know. I couldn't answer that question.
I mean, is it because that's the style of music that you like the best?
Or? I just feel it. I just play what I feel. That's what I do. You know, I don't know why I do it. Just do it. It comes out of me as a natural thing, and I just try to do the best I can do.
Well, the last title...
I do make mistakes. I can't...
Well, everybody makes mistakes, Stas. The last title of your album, King of Honky, on a WRS label, was a fantastic recording. As a matter of fact, I think that the viewers are ready right now to go on stage right here at Ron's Bungalow Inn and listen to a selection from that album, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's do that right now. Let's feature the King of Honky, Stas Golonka, and his Chicago Masters.
Of Las Vegas, the thrills of the circus, and the feeling of Mardi Gras as ETC presents the Mardi Gras Polka Circus Spectacular. One night only, Saturday, February 9th at the beautiful Polonia Banquet Hall, 4604 South Archer Avenue in Chicago. Featuring the greatest circus stars of all time, direct from the Circus Circus Casino in Las Vegas, Nevada. Acrobats, fire eaters, magicians, animal acts, and more. Plus, you can dance to the music of Casey Homel's Polka Stars. A limited amount of reserved ringside seats are now on sale at $7. General admission tickets are only $6. Tickets are available at Bel Air Enterprises by calling area code 708-594-5182. Polonia Banquets at 312-523-7980. Casey Homel at 312-581-1312. Or the ETC Studios at 312-775-9595. It's Las Vegas, the circus and Mardi Gras all rolled into one. It's ETC's Mardi Gras Polka Circus Spectacular, Saturday, February 9th at Polonia.
Paka O delivers in Poland and orders placed in the United States a large variety of modern electronic equipment from the finest manufacturers, including Sony, Hitachi, Panasonic, and many others. Because of their lack of availability, multi-system VCRs and TVs are in great demand in Poland. Paka O maintains an inventory of these items ready for delivery. Information and catalogs are gladly given and orders accepted by all authorized Paka O dealers and by the Paka O Trading Corporation. Call Paka O in Chicago at 782-3933.
Join the many thousands of satisfied van and truck owners who have been taking advantage of Chicagoland's largest inventory of van and truck ladder racks, locks, shelf units, and part bins. It's Keystone Supply, located at 4600 West Lawrence Avenue in Chicago. Let the experts at Keystone select the custom van or truck package designed to meet your needs and to fit your budget. For complete van and truck conversions, call the professionals at Keystone at 202-2680. Keystone, 4600 West Lawrence Avenue in Chicago.
People from all over Chicagoland are stopping in at the Oven Fresh Bakery at 7210 West Foster Avenue, located in the Harlem and Foster Shopping Center. They use only the finest and freshest of ingredients in all their products. Cakes, pies, cookies, breads, and more are baked fresh daily. For special cake and party orders, phone 631-7000. Oven Fresh is the only bakery throughout Chicagoland to carry over 52 different varieties of coffee cakes, a different coffee cake every week of the year. Call Oven Fresh at 631-7000. Remember, for the finest in pastry products, you can't beat Oven Fresh. We're back this month, and we're talking with Stas Golonka from the Chicago Masters, the King of Honky here in Chicago. Stas, you know, as of late,
We don't see you playing too much in the Chicagoland area, and it's a rare treat for everybody when you are in Chicago. So, any particular reason why?
We're on the road quite a bit. After we did some recordings, we've been traveling to the east and to the west. We've been actually all over the country. We also just came out from Wheeling, West Virginia. We're out in Omaha, Nebraska, and we go to Canada. And like I said, we do go to Massachusetts, Connecticut, Pennsylvania. And we do play a lot in Chicago, but on spurts, we're not always here. So like I said, there ain't too many places like Ron's Bungalow Inn to play good polka music now. So it's a fantastic place over at Ron's Bungalow Inn. So for people listening, come down on Sundays. They always have fine polka bands there at Ron's Bungalow Inn. That's on Oak Park Avenue in Stickney.
How much did Ron pay you to say that?
He didn't pay me nothing.
Out of all the many places that you play all over the East Coast, you play the West Coast, you play in Canada. Where's your most favorite spot to play?
Wherever there's people. I enjoy wherever there's good people. Matter of fact, it's so, when you go to these different places, people are so familiar. Like if you're at your hometown, because they're so personal and they're so good to you, you know, and they enjoy it, and that's the main thing that counts. People enjoy themselves, and I enjoy what I do, and that's probably why we're just doing it today as we did before in the past.
Let's talk a little bit about, it's about 7 years ago now, the polka field has been inducted into the Grammy Awards. We seem to think, not only I, but others have voiced their opinion on this segment of the program, that Jimmy Sturr has got this thing all sewn up. What are your feelings about that?
I don't think so. I think, well, Jimmy always does a fine job performing. Jimmy works hard at it, and he's a very good entertainer, and he has a fine band, and I think he deserves everything he can get, because whatever you can get out there, it's out there for the right person, and everybody will have their day to get it when it's due for them. Eddie Bozunczyk won it, I think, twice.
Once
and was nominated, and Stas Golonka was nominated, and a few others. I believe that when time comes around, if you deserve it, you'll get it. So I don't know.
Do you see in the polka field a transition away from the traditional Polish lyrics and more Americanized lyrics where you play on the East Coast?
Oh, yes. A lot of the newer bands, they try to change it around. They add a rock beat to their music and try to fluctuate the Polish words and accent it.
What are your feelings about that?
Well, I don't know. I don't sing that way, so I don't know how they feel. If they feel that's what they want to do, that's their own prerogative to do what they want to do, and that's what they feel like expressing. Everybody has a voice to express themselves in their own way. Everybody's different. And if they feel this is the way they want to express themselves to the public, and they're happy with it, that's why I feel there's nothing wrong with it. I believe that everybody has their own way to doing things. Everybody plays golf different. I'm sure you don't play golf the same way I do, or I don't play golf like Zeke plays golf, but we all have our different styles, and what works for somebody doesn't work for everybody.
Mention Zeke. He's been with you probably the longest, right?
Oh, yes, he's been with me for about 10 years. Originally from Marion Lush's band, originally from Buffalo, New York. I actually moved to Chicago. He's married now and lives in the Glenview or Morton Grove. Uh-huh. Morton Grove. And we've been with me for about 10 years now, on and off on the road.
When you go to maybe audition a new musician that comes with you, what qualities, what kind of things are you looking for?
Just a person that loves to play music and you know, is an honest person. That's all you need. Is honest, a guy that'll be there for the jobs and play the best you can play, you know.
What do you think, in your 30-year span in the polka field, what do you think has been one thing that maybe sticks out in your mind? What is the most memorable event or affair that you've played that really brings back a lot of good memories and a lot of happy times for you?
Well, you got me on that one. They've all been good times. I can't pick one out. They've all been good times. From playing from Brothers 2 all the way to for Mayor Berman, she had the Chicago Fest back in the 70s, I believe it was.
Right.
And playing all over the East Coast and major festivals and just for the people. It's just been...
I can remember going back a long time ago, and I'm sure the recording came out before I ever got in the polka field. You and Eddie Lozunczyk doing a couple of 45s together.
Did 45s together.
High Stash Day. I remember High Stash Day.
Matter of fact, you should get some of those films Eddie has of him playing the accordion, me on drums, and Chet Kovacuski, three-piece band. He has his mother used to tape us at Pulaski Hall.
That's got to be a treat.
A treat. I think those are tapes that even Jackie Gleason we could be beat on those lost tapes.
Tell me about what would you really like to accomplish if If Stas Golonka could make his mark, or you already have, you know what I mean? But I mean, something that would impress in people's minds, something that they could remember you by forever, for infinity, what would one thing that you'd like to do in the poker field before you retire or quit or, you know, whatever?
I would hope that people just respect me, and I respect people, so that's why I would, as long as they, that's the good feeling, just that the other people's respect and they're honest, that's all you can ask from them. I believe most people are. A few aren't, but those I won't talk about. But the ones, just the honest opinion from people and enjoying what they do enjoy. Like, I enjoy performing. They enjoy coming out to the dances and having a good time, and that's all it takes. It takes on both parts. You can't be a super band up there without the people. Without the people dancing and having a good time, the band means nothing. The band does not. It's the people that make the band what they are.
Well, I'll tell you, let's go back on stage right now with Stas Golonka and his honky style of polkas right here at Ron's Bungalow Inn. And we'll be back with more right after this video and right after these announcements.
Eddie Bozoinczyk and the Versatones as they return to Poland May 30th through June the 13th of 1991. The all-inclusive cost from Chicago is $1,850 per person. Join Eddie and the guys for 14 unforgettable days in Warsaw, Zakopane, Kraków, and Częstochowa. Included is round-trip non-stop airfare via LOT wide-body jet, first-class deluxe accommodations, three meals daily, comprehensive sightseeing tours, plus live musical entertainment with Eddie Bozoinczyk's Versatones, the Polish Folk Ensemble, plus the Gorali.
and plenty of free time to visit friends and relatives and do shopping in Poland. If you missed their great tour last year, now's your chance. For reservations and information, contact Beller Enterprises at 7208 South Harlem in Bridgeview or call area code 708-594-5182. 708-594-5182. Polka in Poland in 1991 with Eddie Blazończyk.
Pekka O transfers U.S. dollars to interest-bearing accounts in Poland through orders placed in the United States. Accounts in Poland bear a competitively high interest rate. Pekka O also delivers U.S. dollars to named individuals in Poland and can also guarantee the transfer of dollars from an account in Poland to your account here in the United States. Information is gladly given and transfer orders accepted by all authorized Pekka O dealers and by the Pekka O Trading Corporation, located in Chicago at 333 North Michigan Avenue, or call Pekka O at 782-3933.
The excitement of Las Vegas, the thrills of the circus, and the feeling of Mardi Gras as ETC presents the Mardi Gras Polka Circus Spectacular. One night only, Saturday, February 9th at the beautiful Polonia Banquet Hall, 4604 South Archer Avenue in Chicago. Featuring the greatest circus stars of all time, direct from the Circus Circus Casino in Las Vegas, Nevada. Acrobats, fire eaters, magicians, animal acts, and more. Plus, you can dance to the music of Casey Homel's Polka Stars. A limited amount of reserved ringside seats are now on sale at $7. General admission tickets are only $6. Tickets are available at Belair Enterprises by calling area code 708-594-5182. Polonia Banquets at 312-523-7980. Casey Homel at 312-581-1312. Or the ETC Studios at 312-775-9595. It's Las Vegas, the circus and Mardi Gras all rolled into one. It's ETC's Mardi Gras Polka Circus Spectacular, Saturday, February 9th at Polonia.
We're back and we're winding down on this month's edition of the Polka Videos Spotlight Program. Stas, what's on tap? What's in the future for the Chicago Masters along with yourself?
Looking for at least a healthy New Year's, starting off in 1991. We'll be performing more in Chicago this year also. We'll be playing, matter of fact, coming up in March 2nd, we'll be playing for the Eddie Blazończyk's Versatile Fan Club dance at Polonia Grove. They'll be selling tickets at Bel Air Studios, also at Marge Mahai will be selling at Polonia Grove. That'll be for the big Eddie Blazończyk's Versatile Fan Club on March 2nd. With Stas Golonka, Eddie Blazończyk, and the Verstones, and yours truly, Stas Golonka. Three bands. Yes.
How about a new recording? We have anything coming out?
Yes, we are working on a new recording, hoping to be out by June. We got some in the can yet, but not perfected yet. And you have to go back. As you know, we go back to Youngstown, Ohio, to our recording,
right,
so it's a little traveling to get back there. And sometimes getting there, you feel like you're going to record, and you drive those 10 hours, and you get there, and you feel like you're going to go to sleep. So that's the rough part about it. That's what's good about when you record in Chicago. You just record and go home.
And go to sleep, right?
And let your wife holler at you. You're out too long with the guys.
Mary doesn't do that, does she?
No, my wife's name is Susan.
Susan.
Yes.
Susie.
No, she doesn't holler at all.
She doesn't holler at all?
No.
You're sure?
Positive.
What do you see happening maybe in the polka field? Do you see any younger element? You've got a group of young musicians behind you. You see younger people. How about on the East Coast? You see younger people getting involved in the polka field?
Oh, there's a lot of new bands. As you know, the Toledo Polka Motion has a fine new band. They try to make the transition of polkas into a more of a rock beat. They had some recordings on their last recording. They did some songs that they try to emphasize more in the far out stuff. And if it works for them, it's fine. But I don't think it'll work for me, but it's like there's Scrubby from the Dynatones.
Right.
He always tried something different. He always come up successfully doing something that was all not on the ordinary, and he was successful with his thing. So I imagine the young or old, no matter if you do what you want to do and express yourself, there's going to be some people out there that are going to like what you do and some people that don't like what you do.
Well, you're always going to have that. If there was one person in your lifetime, in your 30-year history in the polka field, that you would really like to thank spread the good wishes to, who would that one person be?
That'd be kind of hard to say right now. I really don't know. Caught me at. There's so many people that did a lot of good things for me, so I couldn't pin it down to one person.
Well, Stanley, I certainly appreciate you being on the program with me this month, and Happy New Year to you.
Keith, to you.
And I wish nothing but the best for Stas Golonka. You've worked for me. I've hired you before,
and
you are always a professional.
Thank you very much.
The music that you perform is second to none. I don't think anybody can play that honky dino sound like you really do. You're one of a kind. And I really mean that. I'm not saying that because you're on the show this month. That's how I feel. And your music, really, you have a beat and a style all your own, and you're often imitated, but you're never duplicated.
Well, thank you very
much. And I wish nothing but the best to you, and hope you continue and stay another 30 years in the polka.
Thank you very much, Keith.
The preceding program was a production of ETC, Ethnic Television Chicago.